Hello students, now we discuss about the lymphatic vessels. In previous class we learned about the lymph, how lymph is formed, and lymphatic vessels are two types. They are capillaries and ducts. We already learned about the capillaries, that are the small vessels. Okay, they contain thin layer, thin endothelium. Through that the lymph is filtered from the blood. Okay, now about the ducts. Okay, here there are two ducts are present. What are they? Right lymphatic duct and left lymphatic duct. How duct is formed? A group of these capillaries, they form as a duct. Okay, here in the right side, completely right side of the head part and neck part, these all parts, they collect lymph from these. Here right side of neck, head part and arm, and next and all parts of the thorax region. In the thorax region, that are lymph is collected from here. Okay, that are that completely the lymph is opens at the junction of right subclavian vein, where that is the right subclavian vein and right jugular vein. Here these are means here lymph is collected from the right side of the head part and neck and thorax region, and that are poured into the at the junction of right subclavian vein. Subclavian means that is from the first rib to sternum part. Here it is the first rib to, it is present at the first rib to sternum, complete sternum it covers. That is collect, that are collect from these parts. And left side, left lymphatic duct, that collects lymph from the left side. Okay, left side of head region, arm, and left side arm and other parts of the thoracic parts. In the thoracic part, they collect left side. Okay, here they are opens at the junction of left subclavian vein. Here it is the right subclavian vein, and here it is the left subclavian vein or left jugular vein. These are in these that lymph is opened. Okay, and here these both left side and right side, they both are opens into the main circulatory system. That both from the left side and the right side, they are pour into the main circulatory system from tissues to heart. Means that collected lymph is collected from right side and left side na, that is poured into the main circulatory system, and that is sent to the here from the tissues that is collected, and that is sent to the venous system, and that is goes to the heart. From that heart, that is again goes to the lungs. Okay, means that for the circulation, it is a lymph is collected from right side and the left side. Now about the lymph nodes. Okay, these lymph nodes that are present in our body from neck part to till end. Okay, means they are formed as nodes. Okay, here from here the lymphatic capillaries, nodes, the ducts are arranged. Okay, here before lymph return to the heart, means already we will discuss that from the left side and from right side, lymph is collected from the head part, neck part and the arm, these all parts. That is collected and from both sides, that is poured into the venous system, and from that venous system, that is goes to the heart. But here before going to the heart, before going to the venous, before enter into the venous system, some contain bacteria and viruses. So here in this WBC, lymph nodes contain WBC, that WBC, they engulf the bacteria and viruses. Okay, these WBC, they engulf the bacteria and viruses, and they clear the blood, and then that goes to the heart. Okay, and next here these are the some organs which are help in the formation of lymphocytes. What are they? Spleen, thymus, tonsils, malt. These are the appendix. These are the main organs which help in the formation of, which produce the lymphocytes. Okay. Spleen, it is also called as a, they in their spleen, that is a lymph, that is present a hemopoietic organ for the before 5th month. At the time of 5th month, 5th month of babies, okay, in them the spleen is worked as a hemopoietic organ. And next, thymus. Thymus is present in the chest region here. That is also one organ which produce the lymphocytes. And next, tonsils that are present in this region. Okay. And next, malt. What is malt? That is a mucosa associated lymphatic tissue. Okay. Malt. Malt means mucosa associated lymphatic tissue. And appendix. Appendix also one of the organ which help in the formation of producing the lymphocytes. In as the appendix is called as a vestigial organ, waste that is not used for us, but in herbivores, in like the cow, buffalo, in that animals, in horse, the appendix is very important for them. Okay. And next, here mainly the lymph contains water and plasma proteins and electrolytes and leukocytes. Leukocytes means WBC. Leukocytes and next lymphocytes, and also they also contain the antibodies. Okay, antibodies and coagulant factors. What are coagulant factors? Coagulant means which help in the coagulation, clotting. Okay, like heparin. Heparin present in this lymph, and they also contain the nutrients, enzymes and the hormones. Okay, these are the about the lymphatic organs. These are mainly spleen, thymus, tonsils, malt and appendix. These are the lymphatic organs which help the formation of lymphocytes. That from that lymphocytes that goes to the these lymph nodes, and through that lymph, through the lymph, what they will do, these lymph, they transport the lymphocytes to the lymphocytes to the bloodstream, and that goes to the all organs.